Hey guys, this is Austin. From time to time, you might want to message someone and have them actually respond. Hi, Wes.
Hi.
You've had this issue before, I hear.
Oh, I have this issue all the time. So, like many people out there, I am on Android.
Yes.
But to the rest of the population, I'm not seen as, you know, Wes or as a nice guy or just someone with the phone of their choice.
You're a green bubble boy.
I am a green bubble boy. I'll set the scene for you a little bit. So imagine there you are, you know, you're on whatever dating app you want. Maybe it's Tinder or Bumble or J-Date, Farmers Only, mutual for our Mormon friends. And then everything's going really well.
I like to think you've tried every single one of those.
I have, actually. Then you get to the point where you gotta exchange phone numbers. Now, usually this is usually a great point in the conversation, but this is where I start to become worried because they're about to find out my dark truth.
Green bubble boy.
I'm a green bubble boy. It's a very real thing. It's ridiculous, but I knew that I needed to find a solution. So,
I mean, there is the solution. You can go to apple.com/iPhone.
Yeah, but I want to find a solution for the cool people like me. We are in a very strange time, obviously, where SMS, despite being the standard for text messaging, really is fading. I mean, you have most of the world that's on like WeChat or Line.
Facebook Messenger.
Yep, and iMessage. And people want more features. They want a cooler messaging experience. It completely makes sense.
But there's still, especially here in the US, there's not one thing to rule them all, right? Typically speaking, a phone number not only allows you to call, but also to text. And if you have iMessage, it's a completely seamless process. So what do you need to get iMessage up on Android? Obviously, there's a Mac Mini involved somehow.
There is. So there have been a few attempts at this throughout the years. A lot of the solutions have been focused on how do we sort of jerry-rig iMessage onto an Android phone, which doesn't really work well.
Sure.
Apple tends to knock those down pretty quick.
Yeah.
But what someone realized kind of recently is, hey, if we just get a Mac computer as the central device to essentially ping the messages through, we might be able to make an app on the phone side that interfaces with that. I don't own any Apple or Mac products. I'm here with my Chromebook and my Android and my, you know, Android Wear device. Yeah, so I wasn't about to go drop a ton of money on a Mac. So in order for this to work, you need a Mac that can run Yosemite. So 10.10 or higher.
That's not bad at all.
In fact, this 2010 with a Core 2 Duo is running High Sierra.
Oh, okay.
Which is amazing, to be perfectly honest.
All it really needs to do is not only run iMessage, but also needs to run, what's the program called?
It's called AirMessage. So,
AirMessage.
And it's only two pieces of software. You have an app on your phone, which is a messaging client that honestly looks pretty identical to Android's Messages app already.
Right.
And then it's a tiny little piece of server-side software that sits on the Mac. And if you want, you can honestly buy a Mac Mini on eBay for under 50 bucks that will do this.
And the other advantage here is not only if you were to do something like this, you have a Mac Mini which is perfectly capable to be run as like a Plex server or anything like that.
Sure.
Or alternatively, if you have a Mac or you have someone else has like an old Mac or even if you have a brand new one, all you do is just load up this piece of software and your Android phone is ready to go with iMessage. iMessage on Android. Blue bubble messaging for your favorite phone.
And it's amazing. They don't even disguise it. They know that this is a problem. It is straight front and center blue bubble messaging.
Oh, it's from the internet. Do you want to really open something from the internet?
I've heard of the internet.
It's not good.
Oh. That was quick. All right, so it's already up. Cool. Love it. Great.
So it just runs as a small program on the top of your bar.
Just a little program on the top of the bar. It'll show you how many clients are connected, which is a nice little security thing.
Yeah.
And just gives you preferences on a few different ways to connect.
Okay.
And this actually is a really big deal for this project because with every other attempt, it's always been very insecure. You've had to go through someone else's
server. Yeah. I don't want to deal with that.
Yeah, that's mad sketchy. Yeah. You just want to connect straight to your device and go.
Oh, so you're going to have to actually do some DNS settings to make sure that the port forwarding is set up?
We are, but the great news is that it's dead simple and it works incredibly well.
So I'm guessing you need to just use an email, right? Unless you had a phone number attached to your Apple ID.
Yeah, so the phone number part is a little sketchy, but when you message someone, it will pop up normally as their email and not a phone number.
Right.
Which, you know, you can just make some excuse, which is actually exactly what I did. I just I don't know why that happened.
I really actually think a fair few people probably use iMessage with emails anyway, right?
I don't know, I'm new to this. And you can also check how often it scans for new messages, which is kind of neat.
So about how often would you typically send it to?
I normally keep it at 1 second, just to make sure that nothing jams up, and then welcome to AirMessage. Yay! So now what we have to do is set up our port forwarding.
So this is gonna be very much dependent on what your router is and everything, but you basically just need to log into the router and clear whichever port that AirMessage wants to be set up to go out to your phone. Because the other advantage here is that you obviously don't need to have your phone on Wi-Fi, right? So I think the phone we're gonna be using here is this S10e, which is specifically not on Wi-Fi, just to show that no matter where you are connected to LTE or whatever, iMessage is going to work exactly the way that you would expect it if you were using an iPhone.
So by using a DDNS service, which there are tons of free amazing ones that are very easy to use, you can basically make a fake website that just points at your IP as it changes, and then you put that website into the app that'll live on your phone.
Okay.
So instead of having to change your IP all the time, which was a problem with one of the older projects that I tried, and changing your IP address every 30 minutes.
Not okay.
It's not okay. So yeah, and with this, all you have to do is just pick what you want your host URL to be.
They have, obviously, Blue Bubble Boy is the only way to go,
and then they have all sorts of
different domains that you can take advantage of. So it's legitimately like a 5-minute setup process on your Mac.
Yeah, it is incredibly quick, incredibly easy, and honestly, just their guide that they have on their website.
Which we'll, of course, we'll link in the description.
Yeah, it's dead simple to use.
Cool. So the next step is we need to download it on the phone.
Yeah, and here's what's really cool. The AirMessage app doesn't have to be sideloaded. It's in the Play Store. This has never been done before. You've always had to sideload it.
Because you're not technically breaking any rules, right? I mean, iMessage is landing on the Mac exactly the way it's intended to be, and there's just an application which just so happens to take that message and forward it on to something else.
Exactly.
Apple messaging on your Android phone, Mac computer required. Man, I'm actually like really surprised to see that in the Play Store.
I think just the amount that it feels like a non-sketchy thing,
it
goes so far.
Hey! So when you type the password incorrectly, it works. All right, so I'm going to message you at Blue Bubble Boy and see if it works.
Yeah, go for it.
So pops up as MMS. Oh, there we go, we're blue. All right.
Cool.
Hi, Bubble.
There it is.
Hey!
Boom.
Hi, Bubble Boy. Dude!
And it even has
seamless.
Yeah, it's that seamless. And even right there in notifications, you have the mark as read or reply, just like you would have.
And again, we're not on Wi-Fi here. So the Mac Mini and my phone is on Wi-Fi, but the S10 is specifically on LTE just to show that once you have this part set up, everything is completely seamless.
Yeah,
can
be
out
anywhere.
Rad.
It's amazing. This has legitimately changed my life. People have, they talk to me.
This is pretty rad. This is properly cool. So if you guys want to get iMessage on your own Androids and ascend to the Blue Bubble Boy realm?
I just like calling it being treated like a normal human being. You too can find love if you install this app, and people will respect you. Your parents will talk to you, your friends will talk to you. Even if you have an LG V40 or
These sound like
a
personal
Galaxy.
Problems, man. These are definitely personal
No,
problems.
It's all because of the blue bubbles. It's not personal. No, it's kind of personal.